Back now on Triad today, and I'm glad that the special guest dropped by here at the Senior Botanical Garden to spend a few minutes with us. She's been on the program before, and we welcome our good friend Ann Gautreaux. She's Senior Director of Public Relations for Trellis Supportive Care. Welcome.
Thank you. Welcome.
Beautiful
good to see
setting.
You.
Oh. Beautiful.
Hey, for those of us that have been social distancing and working from home, couldn't
this is
have
great.
Picked a better studio.
This is great. Hey, let's for folks that don't know, let's remind everybody who Trellis Supportive Care cares for and what areas you serve.
Sure. Well, we're a nonprofit organization, as you know, and we provide hospice care and palliative care. We do a lot of advanced care planning and grief counseling for folks. And we care for people from Greensboro all the way to Yadkinville and Stokes County all the way down to Salisbury.
It's a big area. And I guess one of the questions, I was talking to somebody the other day who knows that, you know, I've had family in hospice care before, and they said, gee, I wonder if, you know, Trellis Supportive Care is even caring for hospice patients right now. I wonder if they're even taking new hospice because of the pandemic and people are, you know, kind of worried. What's the deal?
Yeah, it's a great question, but we absolutely are still caring for our patients and families. In fact, we have about 430 families that are in our care right now receiving hospice care, and we are absolutely accepting new patients. This is not a time to go it alone. I think people are feeling, you know, just the general community is feeling a little vulnerable and anxious. And of course, end of life, that journey is, you know, wrought with anxiety, and people need support and guidance during that time. So yeah, we're absolutely available for we're taking new patients every day.
And a lot of this is at home care where you go in and help folks, and some are at the center itself. Now you had originally scheduled the annual Hope Run for a few weeks from now, but you've changed the way that's going to happen.
We did. You know, everybody started this social distancing weeks and weeks ago, and we made a decision that, unfortunately, we weren't going to be able to have our traditional Hospice Hope Run. But what I'd love your viewers to know is that that is one of our signature fundraising events that we really rely on that revenue every year. And typically, we have about a third to 50% of the people that are going to participate in the run sign up the week of the run or the day of the run.
Right.
We know we're going to lose out on some folks. And so we are asking that people make a donation to the run to help us meet those goals. And there's on the homepage of our website, you can't miss it, there's a Trellis Hope Run logo there, and it'll take you straight to a donations page. So we hope that people will find it in their hearts to continue to support that event for us.
I have kind of one of these twofold questions. One is, how, in what ways is Trellis Supportive Care supporting folks in the community, and how can folks in the community support your mission? So it's sort of a double-edged.
Well, I'm glad you asked. In fact, I probably not be able to name everybody, but I'd love to get a shout out to these Women of Action Winston-Salem who started making masks weeks and weeks ago. We've had to sew gowns. We've got Ardmore Baptist Church group of sewers. Sharp Company donated some patterns for us. So we're seeking support of PPE,
right,
know, protective equipment, although we're set with some official gear finally in that department. But
right. But you're also doing some things from your standpoint to help others, too,
we
even
are.
If they're not patients.
Exactly. In fact, we recognize how important it is for people to have self-care. And we've got this incredible group of people on our team that provide complementary therapies for our patients and families. And we decided, you know what, our team could use a little bit of support in that way. So every day we have a mindfulness moment where we're looking at some meditation, ways to feel grounded and connected. And it's been such a comfort for our team that we've decided to make that public. And so we're sharing some of that on our Facebook and on our website. There's a resources, helpful resources for coping with the COVID.
Well, you just gave me a good point here to mention the website up on screen, www.trellissupport.org, and that's for Trellis Supportive Care, doing great work for the entire community, for their patients, for patients' families. Again, it's trellissupport.org for the radio listening audience. Please check that out and learn about the resources that are available. Again, on a personal note, having been in a situation where I've had both parents and some other loved ones in hospice care, and this is not a commercial, I'm just telling you that hospice is a great organization. It's a great way to help people, and Trellis Supportive Care just does a tremendous job. And I just wanted to say that, and thank you and your team for all the great work you're doing.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
All right, and stay healthy.
We will, absolutely.